제 남편 타일러와 저는 침대에서 참 다양한 것들을 합니다. 영화도 보고 음악도 듣고 게임도 하고 가끔씩은 서로에게 책도 읽어주죠. 오늘은 제가 중학생 때부터 좋아해왔던 어린왕자라는 책을 타일러에게 읽어주기로 했어요. 어린왕자랑 장미꽃이 나오는 그 부분 있죠? 저는 그 부분을 남녀 간의 관계에 대한 상징적인 부분으로 해석을 했는데 꽃이 참 예쁘긴 한데 되게 좀 짜증나게 굴잖아요. 혹시 저에게도 그렇게 꽃 같은 부분이 있는지 한번 물어보기로 했습니다. 일단 한 번도 읽어본 적이 없다고 하니까 한번 읽어주고 시작해보죠. 챕터 8. I soon learned to know this flower better. On the little prince's planet, the flowers had always been very simple. They had only one ring of petals. They took up no room at all. They were a trouble to nobody. One morning, they would appear in the grass, and by night, they would have faded peacefully away. But one day, from a seed blown from no one knew where, a new flower had come up, and the little prince had watched it very closely over this small sprout which was not like any other small sprouts on his planet. It might, you see, have been a new kind of baobab. The shrub soon stopped growing and began to get ready to produce a flower. The little prince, who was present at the first appearance of a huge bud, felt at once that some sort of miraculous operation must emerge from it. But the flower was not satisfied to complete the preparations for her beauty in the shelter of her green chamber. She chose her colors with the greatest care. She adjusted her petals one by one. She did not wish to go out into the world all rumpled like the field poppies. It was only in the full radiance of her beauty that she wished to appear. Oh yes, she was a coquettish creature, and her mysterious adornment lasted for days and days. Then one morning, exactly at sunrise, she suddenly showed herself. And after working with all this painstaking precision, she yawned and said, "Ah, I'm scarcely awake. I beg that you will excuse me. My petals are still all disarranged." But the little prince could not restrain his admiration. "Oh, how beautiful you are. Am I not?" the flower responded sweetly. "And I was born at the same moment as the sun." The little prince could guess easily enough that she was not any too modest, but how moving and exciting she was. "I think it is time for breakfast," she added an instant later. "If you would have the kindness to think of my needs." And the little prince, completely abashed, went to look for a sparkling can of fresh water. So he tended the flower. So too, she began very quickly to torment him with her vanity, which was, if the truth be known, a little difficult to deal with. One day, for instance, when she was speaking of her four thorns, she said to the little prince, "Let the tigers come with their claws. There are no tigers on my planet," the little prince objected. "And anyway, tigers do not eat weeds." "I'm not a weed," the flower replied sweetly. "Please excuse me. I'm not at all afraid of tigers," she went on, "but I have a horror of drafts. I suppose you didn't have a screen for me?" "A horror of drafts? That is bad luck for a planet," remarked the little prince, and added to himself, "This flower is a very complex creature. At night, I want you to put me under a glass glove. It is very cold where you live. In the place I came from." But she interrupted herself at that point. She had come in the form of a seed. She could not have known anything of any other words. Embarrassed over having let herself be caught on the verge of such a naive untruth, she coughed two or three times in order to put the little prince in the wrong. "The screen? I was just going to look for it when you spoke to me." Then she forced her cough a little more so that he should suffer from remorse just the same. So the little prince, in spite of all the good will that was inseparable from his love, had soon come to doubt her. He had taken seriously words which were without importance, and it made him very unhappy. "I ought not to have listened to her," he confided to me one day. "One never ought to listen to the flowers. One should simply look at them and breathe their fragrance. Mine perfumed all my planet, but I did not know how to take pleasure in all her grace. This tale of claws, which disturbed me so much, should only have filled my heart with tenderness and pity." And he continued his confidences. "The fact is that I did not know how to understand anything. I ought to have judged by deeds and not by words. She cast her fragrance and her radiance over me. I ought never to have run away from her. I ought to have guessed all the affection that lay behind her poor little stratagems. Flowers are so inconsistent, but I was too young to know how to love her." Okay, that's it. Chapter 8 finished.
I'm gonna be honest. I missed some part.
That's fine.
I could stay like this, forever following you.
I mean, I can think of one. It's like, at first I said kind of like the, like child. It's still in some form of way. It's like your first love or something like that.
Mm-mm-mm.
Maybe a lot of people go through this type of experience with their first love. They really don't know what they have. Like they don't really know what they have until it's gone. You're my first love. You tend to be sensitive, right? So sometimes, like, if there's something that you don't like, or you're not ready for, or something that just, even if it's a noise, it's like you really don't like it. It's like you almost can't stand it, even if you just dislike it a little bit. And that's kind of different from me, because even if there's something I dislike, I can manage. Sometimes. It's not like I think of like all the good things that you are, right? Like I don't just sit there and think, well, I need to make myself feel better, so let me think of all the good things Yoni is. I just know you. You know, like you're so much more than just that small sensitivity. Right? Like, if you're sensitive about something, yeah, maybe it bothers me for a short while. But it's not only you. That part's not just the only part of you. There's so many parts of you. So I don't think, you know, just like you as me, right? There's, you know, maybe something that bothers you that I do, right? But I'm more than that, right? So yeah, I think everybody's like that. It's far more touching when it's somebody that you're connected to, right? Because we live this life together. The fact that I know who you are is way, that sensitivity is just part of you, which isn't a bad thing. It bothers me, but it's not a bad thing. Yeah, does that make sense? Yeah. You can have both. If you guys liked this type of content, just let us know. We'll maybe continue doing it if it's something that's interesting. This is something that we usually do, not all the time, but sometimes for sure.
Like, right. And we actually make a lot of conversation every day.
Well, the thing is we grow a lot from this.
Right.
Because, you know, we'll kind of share ideas with each other, so maybe this might also help you guys as well. Maybe think about something differently. Yeah.
Say goodnight and let's sleep. Let's first sleep as well.
Alright guys, good night. I hope this was enjoyable. See you next time.
All this painstaking precision. She yawned and pain what?
Painstaking,
okay. And after working with all this
painstaking.
Okay. Staking, okay. And after working with all this painstaking precision.
Painstaking. You said painstaking.
Okay, sorry. Steak. Again.
Just think
okay.
Of steak.
Steak, okay. And after working with all this painstaking.
Why? There's so many parts of you that are for you, okay?
Yeah, I mean, it's just so touching. Go ahead.
Just don't get too far, and I'll be 사랑해요. 나도 사랑해.